I have said many times that history is the power of a people's memory. This is Dr. Katherine Bankole-Medina, and today we explore the general question, why study history? This is a good question, but there is an intrinsic flaw. If you already have an appreciation for history, then this is not a question at all. It's really a criticism. To ask the question, why study history, is an indication of one's own perspective about the relative importance of historical knowledge. Yet, the answer to the question, why study history, is important. For those who study history, the answer is obvious. History is everywhere. It is humanity's memory, the totality of the human experience. It is the foundation of most academic disciplines, and everything we do is predicated on our reaction to the past, either understanding and applying historical knowledge, or choosing to ignore history altogether. For those who think there is no practical value in historical information, try getting a complete health screening for a serious illness without a comprehensive patient history. What if you applied for an important job and were not allowed to list your relevant and extensive work history? You would not be at all competitive for that job. And isn't it evident that in the lives of humans, from a global perspective, that what you did yesterday really can and does have an impact on today? These are simple and straightforward illustrations about how history informs and influences everyday living. However, history is an important discipline in higher education. In many ways, history is like an old photograph. It shows you how you looked at some moment in the past, but there is so much more to understand about that photograph. There is so much more to know and to tell about that image. The historian wants to know, where and when was this image taken? Who took the image and why? Who else is featured? What is happening? As we gaze at our photograph, there are so many questions to ask about its history and origins. Now, the study of history is important for so many reasons. First, critical thinking. The study of history helps you to gather knowledge and information for yourself and to critically process this data. You don't need to rely on someone else's perspective of history. You can form your own understanding. This gives you intellectual power that ultimately leads to social, material, and moral capacity. Second, human diversity. The study of history helps you to understand peoples and cultures that are different from your own. History teaches us how civilizations grew and developed, how people collectively crafted their own lives. This knowledge shows us the contours of human power and how we are different and similar in the preservation of cultures and the task of world building. Number three, problem solving. The study of history gives you a starting point in the processes involved in solving tough problems. We are currently in a global health emergency owing to the onset of the coronavirus. Those who appreciate the importance of history want to know how world societies handled pandemics in the past. We want to know, what did they do that was effective to address the problem? What did they learn that we can benefit from today in this moment? We have to ask questions of history in order to empower ourselves in times of crises so that we can solve human problems. Number four, full knowledge. History gives you a context for the study of events and people who lived in the past. You can learn basic information about historical events and people, including dates, places, terms, concepts. But if you don't know the whole situation, the context, then you really don't know anything. For example, If you don't know the background of the 1896 U.S. Supreme Court case, Plessy versus Ferguson, then you would not have a clear understanding of how the American government enshrined racial inequality and codified the oppression of black people in the flawed separate but equal doctrine. Number 5, intellectual development. An appreciation of history is a sign of intellectual maturity. People need the capacity for critical thinking, sound reasoning, careful judging, and thoughtfulness in conceptualizing. It means that you understand that the past is a foundation for the present and can be a key predictor of the future. And number 6, making sense of humanity. The study of history reinforces our collective sense of humanity. It teaches us what it means to be human and humane in the world. Understanding history can guide your moral and ethical compass as much as religious and spiritual beliefs. Atrocities of the past can be easily repeated if we do not know history. And endeavors that truly help humanity can be recreated with historical knowledge. So, history is the collective memory of people. And if you don't have memory, then you don't really exist. If you do exist, you don't have access to the power that comes directly from historical knowledge. Now, people are dismissive of history for many reasons. Historical studies take time, and some don't want to do the work needed to effectively study history. Others may be very astute and know the power of history, but they fear change. Therefore, they seek to control others by denying and disparaging history. Historical studies are intellectually demanding. So people who are dismissive of history are not interested in exhaustive research, interrogating diverse sources, and locating and gathering disparate information in order to make sense of the past. Then there are also people who often view history from a highly emotional framework. They dislike history because of how it makes them feel. Finally, some people discard history because historical knowledge, like any other form of knowledge, has been misused. This includes systematically ignoring or altering evidence, as well as marginalizing a particular group's presence and contributions to the historical record. The study of history is complex. You can't read a few books on a subject and then be an expert on that subject. Historically minded people spend years researching books, articles, and mostly primary source records. Most historians spend a lifetime learning about the past, and they appreciate the many rewards that come from that process. But you have to have a curious mind, ask thoughtful, probing, and meaningful questions. You need to research deeply and study all of the evidence as much as you possibly can. And always be prepared to find and engage information that does not agree with your own view. Historians do not accept, without question, generic answers from popular culture sources or from simplistic pedestrian notions. So why study history? The study of history is not only necessary to understanding change over time. History is our collective story. It is how we think about and respond to the past. History is our identity. History is everywhere, and everything and everyone has a history. So to be sure, history is knowledge, and it is powerful.